Welcome to Gate School.
Okay. What is mortar? Some of the things, basic things we have already discussed in concrete.
Yes, so, sir, that is cement and sand.
Yes, it is a mixture of cement and fine aggregate.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. Now, if we have to classify the mortars, we can classify based on different types. So, first is we can classify based on bulk density. So, there can be a heavyweight mortar, there can be a light, a normal mortar, and a lightweight mortar. How will the weight be? How will we vary the weight in terms of preparation of mortar? It will depend on the voids. Higher is the void, lighter will be the weight. Then depending on the binding material which is used in the mortar, typically when we are talking about a brick masonry construction, nowadays we will be talking about cement mortar, where we have a mortar of cement and aggregate. Whereas if you see the older constructions, so in the older construction there was lime used as a binding material. So it was a lime mortar also in the earlier times. In some cases you will find gypsum mortar also. Okay. Now, depending on the nature of application, so where do we use the mortar? So where do you find typically the use of mortar? So one is while you are laying the bricks. Another is when you are doing the finishing. When the concrete is done, when everything, the construction is complete, you are doing the finishing work. So there also mortar is used, right? So it depending on the nature of application. And then the last is special mortars. So we have a special categories of mortars also. Some mortars are prepared in such a way that those are fire resistant. So there is a fire resistant material added in the mortar. And we discussed about lightweight material. Then depending on the packing. So sometimes we want, let's suppose for an example, if you are doing an oil digging, there is an oil dig done in the, somewhere deep in the sea. You need to fill that oil well. So what kind of cement, what kind of mortar we want? We want those mortar to be fast settling. So we will have, since it is fast settling, we will have a higher alumina present. So depending on the packing also, we have a special type of mortar. Some mortar we want to be sound absorbing. For some structures we want to be soundproof. We don't want the sound to pass through one from one wall. On that also we have special type of mortar, and then the last is the X-ray shielding. So now if we talk about the properties of mortar, so what is the main purpose of mortar? The main purpose is the binding, it acts as a binding material between two bricks or two stones. If it is a stone structure, then it is a binding material between two stones. If two bricks, it is good bricks. So what do we want? We want good adhesion. Do you know the difference between adhesion and cohesion?
Adhesion is with different bodies and cohesion is with same.
Right. Cohesion is between the same bodies, between the same element. Let's suppose if we are, while we're discussing about the preparation of brick. So in that we discussed cohesion, and cohesion was facilitated by which element? Out of saline?
Silica.
Silica, yes. Silica was responsible for cohesion, and cohesion is present between the same materials, and adhesion is present between the different materials. Okay. Then the next is developing design stress. So whatever design stress is there, if we're talking about the stress of a strength of a brick wall. So what are the two elements? One is brick, one is mortar. So brick strength we have defined. So the mortar strength also should have the same strength as that of a brick. So that is why we want the mortar should have a property of developing the design stress, whatever stress we want to we want the mortar to take. Okay. Then the next is resisting penetration to rainwater, because we know that all the structures will be exposed to water to and fro. There will be rainy season, there will be drying season, there will be some water present in some way or the other. So we want the resistance to be there in the mortar. And the most important thing is it should be cheap, it should be durable, and it should be easily workable. So So what is workable? Remember?
That is easy to work. Flowability, yes. Sir.
Flowability, yes. We discussed in concrete what is workability. So it should be highly workable. The workability should be very high. Okay. And it should be quick settling. Because we don't want, we are putting the mortar between two bricks and it's settling after 7 days. We don't want that to happen. Right?
Sir, aap first ke two points dobara bata sakte hain ki agar network chala gaya tha, I could not hear anything.
The first two points?
Yes, sir.
So, when we are talking about the properties of good mortar, so we are talking about good adhesion between the bricks and the stone. So, mortar acts as a binding material between bricks and stone. So it should have a property that it should be acting as a good adhesive. Fevicol ka kaam karna chahiye, yeah, simple bolu do. It should act as a good fevicol. Okay? And the next is developing design stress. So when we talk about the strength of a brick wall or a masonry wall, so the strength is dependent on two factors. One is the brick, one is the mortar. So the mortar should also have a sufficient strength as that of a brick. So ideally what we expect, the strength of our mortar should be equal to the strength of the bricks.
Okay.
Okay. So these are the two points we discussed, and then the next one was resistance to rain water because it will be exposed to water every time.
Yeah.
Then selection of mortar. So how do we select which type of mortar is used? So when we say mortar, it is a mixture of cement and aggregate. So what will play a role? The major thing will be the ratio of cement and aggregate. Or instead of cement, I would say the binding material. The binding material instead of cement can be lime or gypsum also. So I would say mortar is a mixture of a binding material and a filler. A binding material and an aggregate. So the ratio plays a very important role. So depending on the nature of work, this ratio varies. Like for an example, if we have a plaster work, the ratio can be from 1:3 to 1:4. Okay. And same thing goes for partition wall or parapet walls also. Okay. But if we have, let's suppose if we have a cement concrete road, the ratio will be 1:2. Typically, you will not expect a question in the exam based on the scenario that depending on this, for this nature of water work, for this nature of work, what is the type of mortar that is expected. But just for an understanding, what I would suggest, just go through this table. Just have a feel of these numbers. So, what does 1:3, 1:4, or 1:2, or 1:1 represent, and where these requirements are there? Okay. So that is it about the mortar.
Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed watching this video, then don't forget to like, comment, and share the video. Subscribe to Gate School and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Don't forget to register for our free live classes. Find the link in the description box. This is your chance to prepare yourself with personal trainers.